Thank you, Tim. I have the ominous privilege of inviting you into a call to action over these terribly important issues that we're talking about today. So I just want to say three things as you stand in the hot sun. I will make it quick and brief. My friends, the battle we are fighting isn't just a political battle. And the battle we are fighting isn't just a legal battle, but it's a spiritual battle. And God has given to you and me, followers of Jesus, the most strategic weapon of all to fight spiritual battles, spiritual warfare, and that is pray. And so the first call to action is to be men and women of prayer. And Nick, my new friend here, take a look at Nick's shirt. It says, pray hard. And so that would be the first message to call to action for us, is to pray hard. By the way, we'll let Nick turn around. And then play hard after that. So first, that we would take prayer seriously. That we'd be men and women. And I know many of you in these 2 weeks for the Fortnight for Freedom are praying and fasting. The second challenge would be this. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus called us, his people, salt and light. Interesting thing about salt. Two quick things. One, it enhances flavor. That we are to be salt in the world around us, enhancing the flavor of our culture. But the second most important thing about salt is it is a preserving agent. And you and I are called to be preserving agents in a culture that is morally decaying. And so let us take that challenge seriously. What are ways that you and I can be salt and light? That we can be a preservative agent in a morally decaying world around us. And then lastly, when Jesus described what the kingdom of God was like, he said it's like leaven in a lump of dough. It's really small, and you'd think it's not very effective. But that leaven over time has enormous impact on that lump of dough. And so we challenge you to take action. Pray. Ask the Lord to say, Lord, how do you want me to be salt, a preservative agent in this morally decaying culture? And then, Lord, how can I be leaven? What can I do? Something small, even this gathering, you may think this is small. What impact will it have? It will have impact. To pray, Lord, what impact will that have? It will have great impact, like leaven in the dough. You were handed a card earlier today, and it lists five different things that you can do. Small things, but like leaven, can make a significant difference. So my friends, let's pray hard. Let's seek ways to be salt. And let's look for ways to be leaven to make a difference. Amen?